Good morning, good afternoon, or good night. This is Tercio playing Civ 6. And we just founded the city of Banzabato, however you pronounce that, Congolese. And we are going to continue here. I did find a way to deactivate the turn timer in multiplayer, so that's a good thing. I don't have to worry about hurrying up. So, first thing that we should do at Mbansabata would be, let's see, we could get... Granary's always a good choice. Gives us plus one food, plus the two housing, but we already got five housing, which is, at the moment, enough to start off with. We do have lots of desert. I'll probably go with a granary. I mean, it's always a safe bet. Watermill is also pretty good. It gives us plus one food and plus one production, which helps to build stuff faster. We don't need the housing immediately, so let's go watermill. That will actually help with building the granary later. Oh, yes. And it seems China is friendly with us for some reason. Oh, we've got some embassy requests. Now, China is very friendly with me. And you know what? I think we're going to be friends again with China. I don't mind. Even though he's big and bulky, I can actually get a cultural victory if I wanted to. So, yeah. Let's accept this embassy. We have another embassy... Oh no, Saladin is sending me a warning. My people settle too close. My people will settle where they please. Thank you. That's enough from you, Mr. Saladin. And now my Ingao Mvemba here is going to stay and guard the new city, just in case Saladin goes crazy and decides to invade. There's some barbarian scouts there. I see that a outpost has just spawned. So we're going to actually go and take that out. Arabia is now a theocracy. Sumeria is now in the industrial era.
The purpose of education is to replace an empty mind with an open one.
What just happened? Okay, when my scout got killed in the Arctic. That's nice. And I've met the Japanese Empire.
Ikagaru. Ware wa Nihonkoku no Bushido no Shinkousha. Hōjō Tokimune.
Okay. I want to know where you are. So, where is Hojo's capital? Where are the Japs? Can't see them. Okay. No problem. Mbansa Kongo. Let's see. How far are we in the tech tree? A bit far. Yeah. We need a bit more science. I mean, we got an overwhelming culture here, but we do need to improve our science. I mean, Sumeria is already in the industrial era. We could advance to industrial era as well if we wanted to. I mean, scientific theory is already boosted and it only takes four turns. In fact, I might even do that because I'm not really interested. Well, Potala Palace is actually interesting. Gives us a diplomatic policy slot. But you know what? Yeah, let's go scientific theory. I do have to go through astronomy anyway, so... Yeah, we'll finish banking astronomy and go towards scientific theory. And we're going to have to boost our science. So we're going to start improving our campuses and getting universities. I should also get a theatre square. First, let's get the theatre square up and running. Then we get the university. We'll delete this pin and we're going to put our theatre square here. As for Kinshasa, we can't establish another district at the moment, so I think the best option right now would be to get a workshop up and running just to get that production a bit higher. As for envoys, we're going to send another one to Geneva so we get the additional science boost. We still have one more envoy. We're going to send it over to Kumasi. There we go. And get that bonus of culture. Culture and science, that rules. And we get the wildcard policy slot. Why? Because I think we finished. Yeah, we finished the Forbidden Palace. That's right. Which gives us a new wildcard slot. That is an amazing, amazing wonder. So at the moment, I really don't have another kind of great people points that I'm interested in. So we're going to go with the great scientist points. Always good to have some extra science coming in. And that's it. Let's confirm. And this unit here is going to help support the attack against the barbarians. There's the scout. Oh my. Opera and Ballet is also coming along. It's going to be useful as well. The Bolshoi Theatre is an amazing wonder as well if you're going for a cultural victory. Bumbi! And Bumbi. And Bumbi here. Already has a theatre square. If I wanted to, I could get the amphitheatre up. Watermill. We wouldn't take much advantage of the watermill, wouldn't we? We already got an Mbansa. What we do need in Mbumbi is amenities, but we have to solve that with our entertainment district here. So no worries about that. What we could do is take advantage of the amazing production that Mbumbi has to fill out our trade slots. We just need two more traders. And let's get our units into position. Let's take out the scout. Now, cities that need a trader, certainly Mbansa Bata will need a trader to pour in some food. Maybe Mbansa Kongo as well needs some extra food. I should also make a caravel in Bamba so I can explore the seas and see what other continents there are. Okay, let's take over the outpost and let's shoot these guys down. And take over the spearmen. And that's another barbarian encampment taken down. Oh, we actually get promotion as well, but I can't do that just yet. Okay. Let's have to activate strategic mode. I actually like this mode. I've been playing on my laptop like this. My laptop isn't as powerful as my desktop. So, to reduce the lag, I really have to play on strategic mode. It's pretty cool. I like the artwork on it. But I'm playing on my powerful home desktop, so I'm going to play in the 3D mode. Alright, let's get another trader out. This one is going to go transfer to Mbansa Mbata. And we got another envoy, amazing. Two envoys to be exact. We're going to send them over. Ooh, hold on. Wow, we should be the suzerain of Geneva. Let's do that. 15% science when you're not at war. That is pretty amazing. And as we are Congo, we're pretty peaceful. We don't want any wars, so. That's actually a pretty amazing bonus there. And we do need the extra science, so it's always good. Okay, Mbansa Kongo, our capital. We could get the amphitheatre. It's only three turns. Oh no, no, no. First we should get the Mbansa, just because we're reaching our housing limit here. We should do an Mbansa urgently. In fact, a good Mbansa would come. Really doesn't matter right now. Let's just put it here. I think it would be amazing here. Yeah. Down goes the Mbansa. To increase our population in the capital. We're going to take down that scout. And we're going to garrison some units in our cities. He's going to fortify. Oh, and this trader is going to go to our own cities to get some food. So we can go to the capital, or we could go, yeah, the capital is actually going to give us the most food. Mbanza Kongo. Let's grow this. Let's grow that for a while. Oh, and we got a declaration of friendship. Yeah. I never knew that I would actually get along with China in this game. But we are amigos now. Ooh, look at the Great Wall of China. I'm going to take the yields out because they're annoying. There we go. Great Wall of China. China is another civ that I look forward to playing. I didn't try it yet. But they look pretty cool. They got lots of building bonuses. Their builders actually get an extra charge. The Great Wall is an interesting improvement that you can build. Okay, that's another trader that we have down there. And guess what we're going to build here? We're going to keep building traders because we haven't finished with all the traders yet. Let's actually have a look at our trade routes. We have Mbanza Bata, Mbanza Kongo, Kinshasa, Mbanza Kongo, Bumbi, Kinshasa. We're going to have probably another... We're going to have this route coming out of Mbumbi. Yeah, that's right. And we're going to send it over. Maybe to our friend China to get 11 gold plus 1 science. Yeah, that's an amazing deal. Yes, look at that. All that gold coming, flowing into our cities. Thanks to all the trade. We're going to put this guy over here just to check if any barbarian outposts are going to spawn. This guy should actually do the same. He should come over here just to check if there's any barbarians. And let's take care of that scout. Yay. And we take his dog. Oh yes, we're dog kidnappers. Dog nappers. Perfecto mundo. Alright, claim a great person. Garden of Earthly Delights, okay. Wow. I sneezed, sorry. Let's get our first great artist. Nice. We should take him over yet to this zone here, to the commercial district, because we actually improved it to have slots for great works. Mbamba already finished the harbour. We're at full capacity, so an Mbanza would be actually good. Great Zimbabwe. I think this is one of the only cities I can build Grand Zimbabwe. Has to be next to a commercial hub and next to a cattle resource. So yeah, it would be the only place I can do this. This was going to give me plus 5 gold, 2 great merchant points, and trade routes from the city get plus 2 gold for every bonus resource in the city's territory. I don't think it's that much worth it, even though it gives a whopping 5 gold. Probably it's too much of a hassle. I'm going to go with the Mbanza. Let's go with an Mbanza. I'm going to put our Mbanza here to get that extra pop flowing in. And we get the option of making another district here in Quila. Well, another district. The only district, because we didn't build any. Commercial hub is always welcome. Campus is also almost always welcome. And the theatre square. I should really focus on those. Industrial, commercial, campus, and theatre. Although, maybe I don't need the campus just yet. I mean, I think it's enough with the ones I got here. If I'm going to go for a culture victory, then perhaps. Industrial zone is also pretty nice, especially if I have mines. Adjacent quarry. Oh, we got an adjacent quarry here. Would this be a quarry? No. A mine? No. This would be a mine in the future. So we would actually receive plus 2 here. This would be a mine. This could be a mine as well, because it's a hill. So this would be a plus 2 as well. And potentially a plus 3 if I get this mercury. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think the best spot is going to be this one. Clearly it is, yeah. Let's set up an industrial zone here. It's going to take away a bit of my production. It's going to be worth it. Ooh, I forgot that I could upgrade my units. My Engao and Mvembas don't have to be primitive anymore. Ooh, but I need nitre. Damn it. I don't have any nitre. I only have this one. Oh, that's enough, of course. One nitre is enough. Okay, just stay there. Once I get a builder, he will go and get that nitre resource so we can work and get some musketmen and improve our military. In fact, we have the second biggest military right now after China. Cultural victory, I'm leading. Not bad. Not bad at all. So, now that we got the... Ooh. Maybe we should get the arena to solve our amenity problems. Because we do have a few. Well, maybe I could just purchase it. Purchase the arena outright. Okay. Still, the arena is not an area of effect building. So, it only affects the city that district is owned by. So, it would only affect... the capital. I would need another kind of building in the entertainment complex to actually do the area of effect. So... Amphitheater, 2 turns. I think it's an amazing deal if I do that. I'm just going to pick the builder first, though. Builder, and we're going to get another builder here. 1 turn builders. Amazing. And this guy's just going to fortify... Seems that Saladin is sending troops towards me. He's up to no good. Saladin is up to no good. We're going to send actually some troops down to help. Just in case he gets aggressive. And we got a new trader. Who is probably going to go to a foreign city to grab some gold and stuff. Yep. Yeah. But this time I'm going to send them over to Egypt. I like Egypt as well, so we'll send them to Rakedit. For some more gold. Oh, and I forgot about this great artist here. We're going to make a great work. Yay. But that's all the paintings it could store. I really have to search for a better place for these paintings. So I'm going to have to wait for that. Create an art museum. Okay, I hope these guys are just passing by. Because they will give me some trouble. Oh, we got a barbarian outpost there. And now we're going to grab that nitre. And this guy is probably going to go for the mercury. And then Mbansa Kongo is going to build the university to further our science. While Mbumbi is going to build the amphitheater to further our great writings. These guys are going to stay put at the moment there on top of the silver. While this guy is going to sleep in Mbamba. Just sleep there. We got another trader, who I'll probably just send to China as well, probably to Xi'an for the food. No, it's actually a better, Xi'an. Let's go to Xi'an. Grabbing that extra production, gold, and everything. Pretty neato. Okay, we only need one more trader to fill in all our trade slots. Oh no, we already got 8. Okay, fine. So how much gold are we earning? 11, 11, 7, 11, 7, 7, 7.
And not the other way around.
That is pretty amazing. The amount of gold that I'm gaining from just trading. Is there anything I want to change right now? Not really, because I am going to upgrade my army now, so professional army is really going to come in handy. As for our next civics, I'm ahead in civics, really. Colonialism, urbanism, natural history. Natural history could prove very useful, especially because I'm going the culture route. I'll go civil engineering first for defensive purposes, just in case. So I'm going to have to go mercantilism first. And then I'll go natural history. Then it would be very interesting to go mass media just for Cristo Redentor and Broadway. We'll see. And Kinshasa. What is Kinshasa going to do? You guys are going to make a theatre square. And the best place to do it will be... Let's see. Will I be building a campus? Another kind of area? Woods, hills... Maybe I'll just build it here. I'm not going to complicate the stuff a lot. I just place my districts and that's it. And that's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Remember to leave a thumbs up and join me for more strategy games and more Congo. Oh yes. This is Tercio and I'll see you later.